This one is the HP 320 webcam. It's about $25 to $30. It is a 1080p webcam, so not too bad in terms of specs. This was actually a tip from a commenter on the channel to try this one out versus some of the EMEET ones that I tested earlier in the year. So today I'm going to test it out, see how well the HP C320 does in default, low light, tuned, and tuned low light settings. I'm not going to compare it to anything, this will be a quick video. So let's go and let's see how it does. Okay, so one of the favorite cameras that I tried out last year was the Lenovo FHD Essentials webcam. This is kind of an equivalent to that, I would think, from HP. It does have a fixed mount USB-A cable on it. Not a huge fan of the USB-A cables and the fixed cables for that matter. It feels pretty plasticky. It's kind of got one of those kind of ball mounts on it in terms of how it can be positioned. I do like that it can position left to right if you want to get the right angle on it, so that's kind of a good thing. The base doesn't feel too bad, it's just kind of plasticky. It does have quarter 20 thread on the bottom of it, so it is mountable. It's got only a single microphone array on it and a status light. I can't see that the camera would have a super large sensor in it, so I'm not expecting a lot from it, but let's test out the images and see how it does. Okay, so this is the default image and the default audio from the microphone on the HP FHD webcam, the 320. Okay, so as I was editing this, I realized that there was so much noise from the microphone in the webcam that it's just not usable. Even if you have noise suppression in, say, things like Microsoft Teams or Zoom, I probably wouldn't trust this camera's microphone. You're going to have to get something else. There's a whole lot of hiss coming from this microphone, so just a warning, I guess, if you do pick this one up, use a second microphone with it, or make sure that you test calls with noise suppression, etc., turned on in your video conferencing solutions, because it is a very, very noisy microphone, as you heard. All right, so this is the HP 320 FHD webcam with low light, and also from its default kind of microphone. Just to see what it looks like with hardly any lighting hitting my face. I've got a little bit overhead, kind of simulating overhead lighting. Got some backlighting with my computer gear, kind of as you would expect if you had, say, a window behind you, more or less. But just to see what it looks like in low light. I am not a huge fan of what this one looks like in low light, if I'm honest. But that just means you're going to want to either face a window or get some lights if you're going to use this camera. Okay, so let's now next try to tune the camera to see if we can get it to look a little bit better. All right, so this is the HP FHD 320 webcam. There aren't any software or packages that you load with this one, kind of like the Lenovo, by the way, in that sense. I wasn't able to tune the image that much, so by default, when you actually go into Windows in the settings, the saturation is pretty well cranked. So I just basically turned down the contrast a little bit. It seemed a little bit contrasty. I turned the saturation maybe up a little tiny bit compared. It was already around 70 or so percent on a 0 to 100 scale. So I did what I could to it, but there's not a lot in terms of saving this image because I think it does need quite a bit of light, and I've got a light pushing right at my face at full blast as a ring light at level 10 of 10. Okay, so there wasn't a lot I could do in terms of the HP FHD 320 webcam. Not a lot that I could set, frankly, with its settings other than the four that are exposed to Windows, the UVC webcam. There's no software for it. I would recommend the Lenovo Essentials FHD webcam over this one. The other cameras, the EMEET, all those ones are more or less in the same ballpark. I would almost buy for either the Lenovo for its quality, and I think it does a pretty good job. It's got the wider angle lens and stuff. Or I would spend more or less the same money and get something like a Logitech, the 100 series, because at least you have software that you can dial in the image more. All these cameras are going to have pretty small sensors and not great optics and glass, so they're going to need a lot of light firing at your face. And I had the light at full blast 10 out of 10 on a ring light that's about 2.5-3 feet from my face, but still it could have used even more light than that. So Yeah, that's the HP FHD 320 webcam. Let me know what you think. If you like the video, be sure to give me a like. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel for more webcam reviews, usually more expensive webcam reviews. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.